In today's video, we are going to look how to set up black inside VS Code. I really like to use black inside my Python projects because it's an uncompromised Python code formatter. By using it, as it is explained on their documentation, you agree to cede control to them to reformat your code. This is going to ensure that when you're going to open up a project that you have worked in the past and you have formatted with black, it's going to look always consistent. So I really like to use it inside my project, so even if I write code not in the properly formatted way, black allows me to reformat the code automatically, and then eventually I have my code consistent throughout all my projects. So in today's video we are going to see how to set it up inside Visual Studio Code. It's going to be super simple, just a few steps, and I'm going to show you how to install black on your computer. So the first thing that we need to do is to create a project inside our computer, then we are going to open this project with VS Code, and then we're going to install black. Before we start, I just would like to take a second to ask you to like the video if you like this type of content and subscribe to my channel. It really helps me a lot and it really helps my channel to grow. If you want to support this channel, you can also do so by buying me a coffee or supporting me on Patreon. More information down in the video description below. So the first thing that we need to do is to open Visual Studio Code. So we're going to open it here on our computer, and then we're going to create or open a new folder, which we don't have it already, but we're going to create that. So we're going to say open, and then I go on desktop. Here I'm going to create a new folder, which I'm going to call it Black VS Code. And then I'm going to click on create. And then I click on open. This is going to open the folder inside VS Code. The next step is we are going to create a new file and we're going to call it main.py. The name is not very important of the file. It is important that it has an extension of py because that's a Python file. So inside here, I'm going to copy some boilerplate that I got from the example inside black. So as you can see here, the code right now is not properly formatted. There are some errors that we need to fix. The code is working, so don't get me wrong, you don't need to have black installed if you just want to write simple code that works. But by reformatting this code, it's going to allow us to make it much easier to read it. So the first thing that we need to do in order to reformat code with black inside VS Code, we need to install the extension of Python. This comes very handy if you have not done it already here inside VS Code, because we have these pop-up windows which says, do you want to install the recommended extension for Python? And we can click on install. So then it's installing it for us, and then this is going to help us a lot because there is just one extra step that we need to do and then we are ready to go. So this is still installing. If by any chance you didn't get that message at the bottom and you still want to install the extension, don't worry, like before we are here inside the File Explorer, you could have clicked here on extensions and then you could have looked for Python. So if I search for Python, this should be the first extension that is going to come up, and then you can install it. And this is an extension for Microsoft. So let's go back here. We open the main file here. There is also one other step that we need to do, is to go inside the terminal here and click on New Terminal. And this is going to open a terminal here at the bottom. So what do we need to do is to install black inside our system. And that can be simply done by just saying pip 3, in this case, because I have Python 3, install, and then I have to say black. So this is installing black on my computer. Now there is the final step, which is to let VS Code know that we want to format automatically this code with black. So let's do that. We just have to go inside here at the top, code, preferences, and then we have to go inside settings. Inside here, we need to go for and search for Python formatting provider. And then here we can select black. And then here again in the searching, we can say format on save. And then we press yes, we check these check marks here because we want that we format VS Code automatically formats the file for us on save. So now it's all done. We can close the settings here. We can click here in extension of Python and then we can close this one. We can close the get started. And now we can just press Command S and this is going to save our file. As you can see, the code has been automatically reformatted by black without us having to do anything because we have format on save. Here we can go on and just write something else just to test and we can say variable and then this is we're going to say Federico, but we're going to use the single quotation, so we're going to say Federico and then we press command save and automatically, as you can see, black has reformatted the code for us. The same will work with an array, so we could say array example and this is going to save the array and let's say that we put 1, 2, 3. This is not the right way of formatting an array according to black because there should be a space, so if you press Ctrl S or we set up automatically save the file, this is going to reformat for us. So as we work on the file, black will reformat the file for us, which I believe is extremely helpful. If you don't want to set up the automatic reformatting on save, you can also manually launch black from the terminal. So let's see how we can do that. So here in the terminal, we are inside black VS Code, which is the folder that we just created. And then we can say black, and then we can say dot, or the name of the file. Well, if you press enter, it says all done. One file left unchanged because, of course, we did not make any modification to the file. Let's see if you are quick enough. So we can say here black, and then it says one file reformatted because we made a change and VS Code did not automatically save yet the file for us. That's all for this video. I really hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, please remember to subscribe to my channel and like this video. It really helps a lot with me. And if you want to learn more about LaTeX, if you want to learn more about Python, please check my channel. I have a lot of videos on that. I also have videos on how to create a website with Docusaurus, Retype, Gitbook, which are static site generator that you can create a website simply using Markdown. Thank you very much for watching and see you in the next video.